Chris and I met a good few years ago now, and we've kind of worked on projects over the years before Maribou State. We've kind of been working together for probably 10 years. We almost work as like a yin and yang, where if one person's up, the other person's down, or if somebody's working in a certain way, then it's likely the other person's working in a different way. We can kind of rely on each other to do each kind of task, so it's like if somebody's busy doing one thing, then you know the other person can do the other, and it allows us to work in this kind of as a team, basically, so it allows us to be quite quick with the way we work. Basically, we were in business mode before we was in friendship mode, because we didn't really see eye to eye when we first met. And we were playing in bands at school, and it kind of, due to lack of players, we ended up having to play in a band together, but we didn't really get on. So we kind of have...
So we just stay business mode.
So we just stay business mode. No. So our friendship kind of grew after. So it's kind of nice that we have that. We can switch between it, I think, quite well.
We always knew that when we started the project that we wanted to go into the live world. So because we always, you know, because that's what we set out to do initially, we didn't really feel that pressure, you know, from the start. Kind of thought that, you know, once we'd written an album, that we would then, we didn't want to think about the live thing when we wrote the album, but we knew that afterwards we would translate that into a live show. But yeah, we never really felt any sort of pressure to go into that world.
It's interesting because people who heard our music when we first put out EPs and when we first started going out DJing would have probably never thought that we had the intention of being a live band. And it may probably have looked like we've moved into the live world like everybody does at a certain stage, but like Chris is saying, it's always been the plan. And because we played in bands before together with like electronic instruments as well, it's kind of like we've already had a taste for it and we already roughly knew what we were going to do, or at least we knew it was going to be a big band bringing people in. It wasn't just going to be the two of us. Wasn't going to be on a laptop, it was going to be with instruments.
It was all about just waiting for the right time to do it, I think. Because we could have started it from the very beginning and it would have been very stripped back, I guess. And we really wanted to wait until we were at a level where we could actually just do it properly.
The way we approach electronic music and the way that we kind of always put the organic side of it and the kind of recorded instruments to the front is just from, I think it's just come from growing up and listening to bands that, like, we never listened to the dance music when we was younger. We grew up listening to like rock music or band, like different bands, and we've always played in bands, so we've always really enjoyed live instruments, we've always really enjoyed, like, we're both self-taught guitarists, and I think it's just coming from that side of music meant that we really wanted to do that in our own productions.
That's just the most important thing, I think, to us, is just to retain that.
Yeah.
You know, keeping guitars, pianos and stuff in our music and not sort of straying too far into the electronic world. Like, we're always going to dip our feet in, but I think we just, our main thing is finding a balance, and that's definitely what we tried to do.
Same. No high.
live show at the moment is the same as when we first put it together. We played the first actual show as a band in March, and we've only done six or so shows since then. So it stayed very much the same. There is plans down the line to add stuff into the show, make the band a little bit bigger. But for now, because we've been used to DJing and traveling together as the two of us, and this, the live world is completely new to us, so we want to spend time really like finding our feet as a band, playing with the two new guys we've got, Johnny and Holly, and just get really comfortable with that and get really good at our instruments and just, and yeah, once we're like a really good tight band, then we can start to expand on it and bring new members in, and hopefully up the production side as well.
When we come to writing the next album, we won't let playing live influence us too much. I think, yeah, just because we don't want to restrict ourselves, really.
I think that's it. It's just the restriction. It's like Chris was saying earlier, when we started out writing the album, we never thought about playing live because we knew that that would get us thinking, well, how's this going to sound, or will people dance to this? So we went at it completely with the live project out of our minds, and I hope we do that for the next album.
It's nicer as well because it's meant that we changed a lot of the songs to suit being played in a live environment. And I think that's definitely nice when you go and see an act and things are slightly different from how you listen to it on the record.
Have a good night.